Liftoff for a new missile defense system today. A long-range interceptor missile took off from Vandenberg Air Force Base this afternoon. Today was a test of the system that's widely seen as a counter to North Korea's recent missile tests. Well, CBS 2's Randy Page is live in Santa Monica, where he talked to an expert on nuclear warfare about what that test means today. Randy.
That's exactly right, Pat. It's worth noting that this test had been scheduled for several months, so this isn't something that was done quickly to directly respond to the recent missile test by North Korea. But that shouldn't underscore, experts tell us, the importance of today's developments. The United States today has been able to accomplish something that no nation has ever been able to accomplish before. This launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base this afternoon marks a historic moment. It is the first time the United States has ever tried to shoot down a mock incoming intercontinental ballistic missile, and on the first try, it scored a bullseye. The U.S. Missile Defense Agency says the ground-based interceptor missile was able to seek and destroy the target ICBM.
It worked. That's great.
Bruce Bennett is one of the nation's leading experts in strategic nuclear warfare in North Korea. He says today's successful test comes at a good time.
Back on January 1st, Kim Jong-un, the leader of North Korea, gave his New Year's Day speech, said he was going to test an ICBM this year. And the bottom line is, I think this is an American attempt to say, even if you launch one, we can take it down.
And Bennett says today's successful test is an amazing accomplishment. First, the U.S. launched a mock ICBM from an atoll in the Pacific. Then the interceptor missile launched from Vandenberg Air Force Base maneuvered itself into the path of the incoming ICBM. Bennett says North Korea has only tested short-range ballistic missiles, but if it ever does develop an intercontinental ballistic missile, today's launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base sends a powerful message about the potential consequences of targeting an ICBM at the United States.
Kim Jong-un is not going to fire a missile at the United States if he knows that it's going to be intercepted and destroyed, because he knows then we will have to retaliate. An adversary is deterred when he thinks the benefits of the action he takes do not exceed the costs he's going to suffer. We've got to convince him that the costs are too great, not only of using nuclear weapons, but even of testing them. And we haven't gotten there yet.
It's worth noting that this whole idea of tracking an incoming ballistic missile and shooting it out of the sky was first mentioned way back in 1983 by then President Ronald Reagan. Back in those days, many of the scientists said this is really more the work of science fiction. But as of today, it is no longer fiction, and it is something that is seen not only here, but around the world.